God bless you. God bless America. God bless Alabama, and God bless Donald J. Trump.
And you're all seeing what has happened in Afghanistan. And it is really a disgrace of what is happening. President Biden is handing over billions of dollars of military equipment, air bases, and embassy to the terrorists. And he has made America look weak on the national stage. President Trump never made America look weak. We'll have a new president in 2024. And after Biden, you tell me who that president's going to be.
USA! 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 God bless you for being here. God bless President Trump. God bless Alabama. And God bless America.
There's a video playing right now on screen. Let's take a listen.
Some of you boys, I know, are wondering Whether or not you'll chicken out under fire, don't worry about it. I can assure you that you will all do your duty. The Nazis are the enemy. Wade into them. Spill their blood. Shoot them in the belly. When you put your hand into a bunch of goo that a moment before was your best friend's face, you know what to do. Now, there's another thing I want you to remember. I don't want to get any messages saying that we are holding our position. We're not holding anything. Let the Hun do that. We are advancing constantly, and we're not interested in holding on to anything except the enemy. We're going to hold on to him by the nose, and we're going to kick him in the ass. We're going to kick the hell out of him all the time, and we're going to go through him like crap through a goose. Now, there's one thing that you men will be able to say when you get back home. And you may thank God for it. 30 years from now, when you're sitting around your fireside with your grandson on your knee, and he asks you, what did you do in the great World War II? You won't have to say, well, I shoveled shit in Louisiana. All right, now you sons of bitches, you know how I feel. I will be proud to lead you wonderful guys into battle anytime, anywhere. That's all.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 45th President of the United States of America, Donald J. Trump.
And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that life to me. And I gladly stand up next to you when they linger still today. Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, and New York to LA, where there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, there ain't no doubt I love this land.
big crowd, I'll tell you. This goes all the way back.
I wish they'd show it because they just don't do that. You know, they don't like to. This goes all the way back. I just looked at it on television, but it's our television. We show it, but they don't show it. You know why? Because they're fake news, right? Hello, Alabama, and I'm thrilled to be back. We're going to fire Nancy Pelosi, Chuck Schumer, Joe Biden, and the radical left. We're going to make America great again. We have been making it so great. Now they're biting into that, but we're not going to let that happen. We can never let that happen. That's why, you know, I had the idea, all my ideas. Someday they're going to tell me how to do things. But I like the George Patton piece. Did you like that, General Patton? I thought so. Because we're getting a little tired of the woke generals that we have, right? Where they move our military out before they move our civilians and before they move $83 billion worth of equipment. Let's move them out. And the Taliban looks and they say, I can't believe it. This could only happen to us. I can't believe it. The military left. They go in. We have 45,000 people there, Americans, anywhere from, I guess, 15. They have no idea how many. That's even worse. They say it could be 10. Oh, could also be 45,000, but it's a lot of people and equipment like nobody has anywhere in the world. But I said that Biden would embolden America's enemies, and that's what he's done, and that the radical Democrat socialist agenda would set our nation on the road to economic ruin. You look at what's going on with inflation. Has anyone noticed that your gasoline is now at levels that you never thought you'd see again 6 months ago? So we had $1.87 a gallon, and we had a thriving industry, energy independent. Nobody thought would ever be energy independent. We didn't need the Middle East. And now you have over $5 in many cases, and it's going, even here, it's going to be over $5 very soon. And I saw the other day, before this whole thing with Afghanistan started, because right now, nobody's talking even about energy, even about the horrible border condition that they're allowing millions of people to come into our country, people that we have no idea, but people aren't talking about that, talking about the disaster of Afghanistan. Not only have my predictions come 100% true, but it's even worse than any of us could have imagined. In our worst nightmare, nobody thought this kind of thing could happen. Biden has obliterated our border, given up our energy independence, caused soaring inflation. He failed totally on economic and policies. I mean, you look at what's going on, it's crazy. And the senators that voted for this $1.2 trillion bill, of which they call it infrastructure, but only 11% is infrastructure. Where the hell are these people coming from? It's the roadmap. They call it the glide path. It's the roadmap to the Green New Deal, conceived and dedicated by AOC, a real beauty. She's a real beauty. She knows more about the environment. I don't think she ever even took, did she ever take a course? She wasn't a good student. Did she ever take a course on the environment? Remember when we first said, you have 12 years to live, she said 2 years ago. That means you have, right now you're about 9.5 years. Somehow you're not worried about that, but you are worried about China and Russia and other places, okay? All right? We rebuilt our military stronger, bigger, better than ever before, and now I see it being dissipated and being given. Our military is being given to the enemy. Biden failed totally on the pandemic, and he's now overseeing the greatest foreign policy humiliation in the history of the United States of America. This is the greatest humiliation I've ever seen. Biden's botched exit in Afghanistan is the most astonishing display of gross incompetence by a nation's leader, perhaps at any time that anybody's ever seen. Name another situation like this. Vietnam looks like a masterclass in strategy compared to Joe Biden's
catastrophe. And it didn't have to happen. All he had to do is leave the soldiers there until everything's out. Our citizens, our weapons. Then you bomb the hell out of the bases. We have five bases. And you say, bye-bye. You say, bye-bye. The scene of those big, giant planes taking off with people hanging on the sides and falling off. There'll never be anything like that. That's worse than the helicopters. You remember the helicopters taking off the roofs? This blows it away. Not even a contest. This will go down as one of the great military defeats of all time, and it did not have to happen that way. This is not a withdrawal. This was a total surrender. This surrender for no reason. They weren't asking. We had them. I dealt with Abdul. He was the leader. I said, Abdul, anything happens, we are going to rain terror upon you. It will be a terrible thing. Don't touch our American citizens. Don't ever come to our country. Don't ever come to our country. And you're going to continue fighting your civil war. I can't do that. They've been fighting it for hundreds of years. That's what they do, is they fight. And they're good fighters. But I had a good relationship other than that one statement. I said, after I said that, I said, now let's get down to business. We had a conditions-based agreement. And they didn't meet the first two conditions, and we hit them hard. Sometimes I went to Dover Air Force Base. That's where the bodies of the soldiers would come in. And I'd see them bringing a young man, young woman in a coffin. And I'd be with the parents. And I've told this story a couple of times. The parents would sometimes be unbelievable. You would almost not understand. It was like, sir, it's so great to meet you. And they'd always tell stories about their child. Sir, my son could throw a football so long. He was a quarterback in high school. He was a quarterback in college. Sir, I think he could have been in the NFL. He was really good. He was so great. And we're waiting for the plane to come in. And sometimes they'd be talking about their daughter. Lots of daughters were killed coming out of the Middle East. My daughter was so beautiful, sir. She was so incredible. She was the greatest. And I'd say to the general and the colonel that ran Dover, the great people, we have great, by the way, we have great generals. We have great generals. The ones you see on television are not the ones that are great. But when Biden took office, he foolishly tore up our really good plan. Again, not a plan, it's conditions. We do this, we do this, we do this. If you don't do these things, we're not going to do it. And then we start dropping bombs all over the place. And they say, you know what? We're going to do it. We've decided to do it. Now, we had a good understanding. They always hate it. Remember when I came in, Obama said, the worst problem we have is North Korea, Kim Jong-un. I said, what's the problem? He said, I think you're going to go to war with North Korea. I said, have you ever called him? No. Actually, he called him 14 times and was not responded to, but he told me no, but that wasn't truthful. I said, it would be good to talk to him, wouldn't you? You know, rather than nuclear war, wouldn't it be nice? Anyway, through a series of events, I did talk to him, and it was nasty at the beginning, remember? He said, we have a red button on my desk, and I said, I have a much bigger red button. And my red button works, and yours doesn't. And anyway, it was very nasty. And then all of a sudden, it became a love fest. It became great. Right. And I went to North Korea, went to South Korea, went across the line. We got along great. There was no nuclear catastrophe. But you got to be careful, because he does not respect Joe Biden. A majority of Americans, 55%, want audits of the votes. They want audits. And they want the forensic audits. They don't want the bullshit audits. And 88% of the American citizens, of our citizens, of our great people, are demanding voter ID. A hell of a crowd. I want to tell you, this crowd goes so far back. See the cameras? We shouldn't give that to the media.
because all they do is they block the viewer. They don't say the truth anyway. This crowd, see where this is, goes hundreds of yards behind those cameras. Look at that. Man. Tommy is, I'd love to see Tommy. I love Tommy. He's doing a great job. I said, you know, Tommy, you're running for Senate, and he did a good job. He was a natural, and he was a rah-rah coach, but he was a great coach. I asked Urban Myers, how good a coach was Tommy Tuberville? He said, he beat me twice. He's the only one that beat me twice. But I said, Tommy, you beat Alabama six times. I said, how can you possibly expect the people of Alabama to vote for you? He said, sir, because I gave them a coach named Saban. Because of me. I said, Tommy, that's the coolest answer I've ever heard. And you voted him in, and he's been a great senator. He's been phenomenal. Thank you very much. Thank you, Tommy. I said, they're spying on my campaign, and the world went crazy. I thought it was just an innocent statement, because we know they're dishonest. The world went crazy when I said they're spying, and it turned out to be true. They perpetrated the Russia hoax. They framed General Flynn. They conducted the Mueller witch hunt, never-ending Mueller witch hunt. They're continuing to do it with very dishonest, highly political prosecutors all over the place. They're using justice to go after Republicans, and we can't let that happen because, again, we're not going to have a country left. And they pushed the impeachment hoax number one and impeachment hoax number two, who ruthlessly smeared Brett Kavanaugh. Do you remember how they went after Brett Kavanaugh? He was with this one. He was with that one. He wasn't with any of them. And they knew that. But, you know, they're trying to scare our Supreme Court. And they're trying to scare people like Bill Barr and others by going after them. They try and scare them because they say they're going to pack the court or they're going to impeach Bill Barr. And, you know, it changes some people. It really does. It changes them. It scares them. They don't want that to happen. They talk about they want to impeach Kavanaugh. You know what they want to impeach him for? Nothing. He didn't do anything wrong. In fact, the opposite. They did everything wrong. They were total dishonest people. One of the most horrendous hearings anyone's seen. They covered up the origins of the China virus, and they censored all information about Joe Biden and Hunter Biden and all of the corruption in that family. Just recently, it was revealed that Google rewrote its whole program. You saw that. In order to target Donald Trump. They targeted me. And yet we still got 75 million votes. How the hell did we do that? But really, the number wasn't 75 million. I believe the number was many, many, many millions more. You know, it's funny. I have a rally like this that goes way the hell back. By the way, it's starting to rain. I will prove to you it's my hair. I will prove it. But everyone here knows that the radical left will stop at nothing to destroy the America we love. We're not going to let it happen. All of you in Alabama and with conservative patriots like Mo Brooks and others and all of the names I mentioned are fighting for us in Washington. And I have never been more confident that we will defeat the radical left. And we have to. We don't have a choice. These are vicious people and they stick together. They don't have Mitt Romney and these guys that go off on their own. They don't have people like that. Little Ben Sass, he's a nothing. They don't have people like this. They have people that stick together. I respect them for that, but I don't respect them for trying to destroy our country. With a Republican Congress, we will fight for more jobs, for American families, fair trade for American workers, and we've done more on trade deals than any other administration in the history of our country. Including the China deal, which I don't even talk about anymore because of COVID, but the China deal has made our farmers rich. Our farmers and manufacturers have never done better.
and more American factories forging more products stamped with that very beautiful phrase, made in the USA. So in conclusion, our movement is up against some of the most sinister forces and entrenched interests that anyone can even imagine. But no matter how big our way of life, no matter how big our country or how powerful they may seem, you must never forget this nation does not belong to them. This nation belongs to you. This is your home. This is your heritage. And our magnificent American liberty is your God-given right. The citizens of the United States of America will not be dictated to and talked down to by incompetent politicians, corrupt tyrants, left-wing bullies, or socialist bureaucrats in Washington, D.C., a place that I got to know very, very well. We are descended from the heroes and the patriots, the pioneers and the legends who tamed the great wilderness, who settled this vast continent, and who laid down the railroads, raised up the skyscrapers, and poured out their blood, sweat, and tears to build this country into the greatest nation in the history of the world. And we are not going to let it be taken away from us under any circumstances. Our ancestors crushed fascism. Beneath the weight of American tanks, they toppled communism by the strength of American culture. And now we will defeat woke radicalism and a continuation of communism, because that's what this is heading for. We will defeat it with the sheer power of American pride and American brain. Our leaders may not believe in the destiny of America. They may not believe in the destiny of America. I really don't believe in many ways they love our country. But we do, and we are not going to let anybody take that love away. We know that there is no mountain we cannot climb, there is no summit we cannot reach, and there is no challenge we cannot meet. We are Americans, and the future belongs to us. We are going to have a great future. We are going to turn this mess around. This is a horrible thing that's happening to our country. We're left at all over the world. We're not going to be left at anymore. This is a horrible, horrible thing, and it's going to go on for a while, but we've got to end it. We cannot let this happen. They're destroying our country. We will not bend. We will not break. We will not yield. We will never give in. We will never give up. We will never back down. We will never, ever surrender. My fellow Americans, our movement is far from over. In fact, our fight has only just begun. In the history of our country, there has never been a movement like this. There's never been anything like it. We will make America powerful again. We will make America wealthy again. We will make America strong again. We will make America, despite what you're seeing today, so sad and so pathetic, we will make America proud again. We will make America safe again. And you know what it is. We will make America great again. Thank you, Alabama. God bless you all. Thank you.